Thank you for joining us. Nobel Prize recipient Albert Schweitzer once said, "Until he extends the circle of his compassion to all living things, man will not himself find peace." We have a moral responsibility to protect nature, the environment worldwide, and all life, including animals, of course. And this is true in Israel as well. Joining us now from Tel Aviv is Riki, founder of SOS Pets. Shalom, Riki. Please tell us about SOS Pets.
Hello, Richard. SOS Pets is our organization in Israel that rescues and cares for abandoned and stray cats and dogs throughout Israel. We are different from most other organizations worldwide in that we place cats and dogs in foster homes rather than in cages. In fact, Richard, we are the first organization to implement this foster care system. We care for each and every pet until a new home is found for them. SOS Pets is funded by donations only, and the ongoing challenge and need is to receive support from anyone who cares to help us save the lives of cats and dogs in Israel. When coming to Israel, everyone in your audience is welcome to visit us. We will be very happy to show you what we are doing.
Thank you, Riki. I admire and respect the very important work you're doing.
Thank you, Richard.
We'll have Keren Strauss joining us in a moment to tell us more about SOS Pets from Israel right after these messages.
You know you need CoQ10 and fish oil for your heart. You also know you need a multivitamin to maintain your health. But what you don't know is that an award-winning CoQ10, fish oil, and multivitamin are all made by Life Extension. Why settle for less than the power of science, the power of life, the power of Life Extension?
At Gardens Wellness Center, we provide a full menu of holistic services under one roof. Services to heal the body through chiropractic care, acupuncture, and colon hydrotherapy. And services to heal the mind through hypnotherapy, neurolinguistic programming, and life coaching. We practice functional and Chinese medicine and offer a full herbal pharmacy. Visit us today and take charge of your health.
When I was young, it seemed that life was so wonderful. A miracle. Oh, it was beautiful, magical.
And then they showed me a world.
Find magic again. Sprout by HP. With Intel RealSense technology inside, now you can bend the rules of creativity outside.
My name is Tali, I'm 20 years old, and I've been volunteering for about a year now in SOS in Israel. The organization was started over 30 years ago by Riki Bassry, and it's been working since to save as many dogs and cats from euthanization and find them proper homes. Every month, the organization neuters about 300 to 400 street cats in order to prevent the reproduction of cats that just can't find them homes.
We do everything we can to save and improve the quality of life of the animals that we receive, and we save almost 3,500 dogs a year.
Our number one motto in this organization is to never euthanize a cat or a dog. Every cat and dog can find a home.
Lately, because of the situation in the South, there's been an influx of abandoned dogs. This is another aspect, another sad aspect of the war. And we've been doing everything we can to save these animals. There's a lot of abandonments. The city shelters are full. A lot of dogs run away from their homes. People don't adopt this time. We've been struggling to keep up with all the demand.
Not only taking them from the shelters down south and bringing them here requires money, but we also make sure that the dogs, before they're sent to their proper homes, are looking after, checked up to see if they're healthy, if they're all vaccinated. Some of them even get neutered or castrated before they find the homes. So every single aspect of that takes money, and we're doing our best, but it's really difficult.
Any dollar you give will help us save these animals, will help us save a life. Our resources are very low, so we really need your help.
So please help us, and thank you.
With us now is Keren Strauss. Keren, it's such a pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you for having me.
We always have too often elderly gentlemen, statesmen, we have politicians, members of Congress, members of Knesset, and rarely do we have an elegant, beautiful young lady from Israel such as yourself. And even more importantly, you're involved in such an important cause. She's with SOS Pets in Israel, a unique organization in a difficult part of the world. Tell us about SOS Pets.
So SOS Pets is solely sustaining on donations, generous donations from people for over 30 years. And every month we rescue about 200 pets, trying to find them homes from foster homes to permanent homes.
This is most interesting. I'd like you to elaborate a little on the concept of finding foster homes for animals.
Well, sometimes it's difficult to find permanent homes for the animals. So instead of keeping them in the pound, SOS Pets actually saves them from the pound, because the life expectancy in the pound is roughly 10 days if the animal isn't adopted. So SOS Animals, SOS Pets, will actually take them from the pound and find them foster homes instead of keeping them in kennels, instead of leaving them alone. They find them foster homes, temporary homes that people, you know, can offer for a short period of time until they find a permanent home.
How interesting it is that such unspeakable atrocities are perpetrated against innocent animals throughout the world, and of course, even in Israel. And I would presume, though, that Israel is able and willing to be more humane than neighboring countries. But tell us more about the history of animal rights in Israel.
SOS Pets focuses on education. So we work on finding the pets, if it's dogs or cats, homes that are suitable for them, that will take care of them. We see it as the people's responsibility to take care of animals. And what we try to do is we actually involve the schools, and there's a whole education system involved, not just with SOS Pets, but we do have programs within schools to educate children, to educate teenagers as to how to be responsible, how to take care of pets, that their role in our world and their role to be responsible adults and how to take care of the other living beings within our world.
Teaching people to have compassion.
Compassion.
Yeah, the founder, Riki, actually created programs on this particular subject, teaching people to be compassionate. Could you elaborate on that a little?
Well, we do. We honestly, she founded SOS Chayot, SOS Pets, and her background is actually psychology, and she worked in the school system. So she started programs that actually educate the children about compassion. They need to learn emotion and compassion and responsibility towards animals in our world.
Well, it's unfortunate that she couldn't be here today, because we could have discussed this with her as well. But we'll visit in Israel. We are here in the United States right now. But we certainly have to tour the facilities and get more in depth. But what I find interesting is Israel, the Jewish homeland, where the remnant of the Jewish people have come back to reclaim their heritage. And with all of the suffering that the Jewish people have suffered throughout history, it's interesting that there is, of course, this very great imperative to teach compassion to younger children who may be distracted by other bad things that happen in a rough neighborhood.
Well, it's life. It's to teach them how to be compassionate to life, to other living beings, all living beings.
Speaking of education, you have vehicles that tour the neighborhoods and pick up animals, I understand. And in addition to the fact that you go to schools and educate and teach, so you show presentations to children in schools and so forth. Tell us about the mobile services you provide.
Sure. So there actually, SOS Pets has a few ambulances, or what we call ambulances, and that's actually something that we're looking to fundraise for because we need more. There are vehicles that go around, pick up stray cats, provide them with the medical attention that they need, vet care, food, bring them to facilities and to different areas that have feeding stations, and we provide the food and take care of them. So that's one of the issues that we are focused on right now, is getting more ambulances so that we can help more pets. Again, we rescue about 200 pets a month, and you know, another ambulance, even $1 from each person would allow us to save an animal's life.
Well, we should elaborate on the need for fundraising, but before we do, I'd like to ask you a little bit about another very important point. The founder of SOS Pets, Riki, actually volunteered for the SPCA, and she was unhappy when she heard that sometimes animals just are euthanized when no home is found for them, but SOS Pets does not do that. They absolutely do not.
No, just the opposite. We try to find, if it's short-term housing, if we can't find a long-term care for a pet, we will find them short-term housing. We'll find them a foster parent. So just to avoid that, no euthanization, absolutely not.
How is SOS Pets funded?
It's 100% through public donations.
I would think that governments all over the world should actually support such causes, here in the United States and in Israel, everywhere. I think animals are just as important, really, and the environment as well, as human beings, in
Absolutely.
My opinion.
It's life. It's life, and we want to save these lives.
What can our audience do to show their support for cats and dogs, animals in Israel?
We need donations. Even a dollar per person will help save an animal's life. It's purely about donations right now. We need to get more ambulances. We need to get more vet centers set up. We need to get more feeding stations set up. So it really just is about any dollar that can be spared and given to save an animal's life.
$1 per person every now and then. Good Lord, we reach 44 million homes. If only some people in our audience would perhaps share some compassion for animals as well. But you also are funding not only animal care, but education. Tell us more about the educational projects that SOS Pets is involved with.
Right, so SOS Pets actually has a number of different divisions. We have one division that focuses on rescuing dogs, another division that focuses on rescuing cats, and another division that focuses on education. And this is educating students, educating children of all ages. Again, teaching them compassion, teaching them responsibility. So that's another aspect that we need support for, is to be able to bring these programs into the school, teach children how to respect other lives, teach them compassion, teach them responsibility, how to take care of another living being.
So many of our viewers visit Israel on Federation trips and other organizational events. Can people from the United States also visit SOS Pets in Israel?
Absolutely. There's an adoption day every Saturday at one of the facilities in Herzliya. It's absolutely beautiful. It's a space that has actually been donated to SOS, and there are many other facilities. We have offices all around Tel Aviv and other neighboring cities, and we'd be happy to show you around and show you, meet some of the animals and meet some of the other volunteers. It's absolutely beautiful, and we need some support, and we would love to educate more people about it.
I was amused to see an event you had where black cats and black dogs were shown on a specific day, because sadly and insanely, black animals are often treated badly. And could you elaborate on that PR event?
Yes, we had the day to rescue the black cats and black dogs, because for some reason, I don't know if it's the superstitious aspect to it, but people tend to not adopt black colored pets. They prefer to adopt colorful pets. So we're trying to also raise awareness to that and educate people in that, and hopefully get them over their superstitions. Because clearly, you know, people say it's bad luck if a black cat crosses your path. Well, really, I mean, it's obviously the cat's bad luck, because nobody wants to adopt that black cat.
Well, I had a black cat, and I think animals are just wonderful. What a pity that we live in such a wonderful world, but there's so much fundamentalism, obscurantism, and irrationalism that plagues our world, actually. But I'd like again to end on the question of fundraising. Please emphasize again for our audience the great need for helping animals in Israel at SOS Pets.
Absolutely. We need more vet centers, we need more ambulances, we need more education. And we need, you know, more marketing and awareness on the topic of just, it's saving animals, it's saving lives, and that's what's important. We could save double than that with a small amount of donations from your viewers.
Keren, it's such an important cause, and I'm so full of admiration for what you're doing. We'll do our utmost to help SOS Pets. We'll create a commercial for you. We'll run it on the Shalom Show on a daily basis. And thank you again so very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'll be right back.
You know you need CoQ10 and fish oil for your heart. You also know you need a multivitamin to maintain your health. But what you don't know is that an award-winning CoQ10, fish oil, and multivitamin are all made by Life Extension. Why settle for less than the power of science, the power of life, the power of Life Extension?
At Gardens Wellness Center, we provide a full menu of holistic services under one roof. Services to heal the body through chiropractic care, acupuncture, and colon hydrotherapy. And services to heal the mind through hypnotherapy, neurolinguistic programming, and life coaching. We practice functional and Chinese medicine and offer a full herbal pharmacy. Visit us today and take charge of your health.
When I was young, it seemed that life was so wonderful. A miracle. Oh, it was beautiful, magical. And then they showed me a world.
Find magic again. Sprout by HP. With Intel RealSense technology inside, now you can bend the rules of creativity outside.
I read Life Extension magazine to keep abreast of medical discoveries that can literally save my life. Life Extension's track record dating back to 1980 shows that they are decades ahead of conventional medicine in identifying proven methods to prevent and treat the diseases of aging. Reading Life Extension magazine will empower you to take control over your health and longevity. And as a special favor to me, the Life Extension Foundation will give a free one-year subscription to anyone today. Just call the number on this screen to obtain your free Life Extension subscription. There's no cost, no obligation, just the opportunity to discover solid options to live longer and better. Call the number on the screen today to start receiving Life Extension magazine each month.
Take charge of your health. Get your free subscription to Life Extension magazine now by calling toll-free 1-800-509-9117 or visit www.lef.org.
In the summer of 2013, a group of animal rights activists decided to plan a march for the animals that will call everyone in Israel and worldwide to uncover their blindfolds and look into the eyes of the animals. The initiative that for the first time brought different animal rights organizations to collaborate together for one cause, to denounce any type of animal abuse, got a wide media interest and the support of many Israeli opinion leaders that called the public to come to the march and to look into the eyes of the animals. Authority permits were given, police roadblock was stationed, and on the night of August 24th, the Great March for the Animals was good to go. Thousands of people had arrived to the starting point on Rothschild Boulevard. Young and old, kids and youth, religious and secular, placed themselves in one of the five main groups of the march, and together they shouted, no more. No more abuse and killing of animals in the food industry. No more killing of dogs and cats. No more animal experiments. No more animal abuse in the form of entertainment and the killing of wild animals. No more to the fur and leather industry. The impressive march crossed through the center of Tel Aviv, all the way to the ending point where the main ceremony took place.
Tov Tel Aviv shel chemla! Toda raba lekol echad veechad mikem sheigatem en haerev kedei lishloach mikan mimerkaz Tel Aviv or gadol shel daaga ichpatiyut ומחשבה על האחר. כולנו יחד מסתכלים לבעלי החיים בעיניים, רואים אותם, שומעים אותם, מרגישים אותם, ומחליטים יחד עכשיו לשים קץ לסבלם.
בקרבתנו, חלקם קרובים במרחק נגיעה, חלקם רחוקים, מאחורי סורגים, מעבר לקירות אטומים, במכלאות, ברפתות, בדירים, בגני החיות, במעבדות, במפעלים. חלקם עדיין חופשיים, אך נתונים בסכנה. חלקם כבר נכחדו. חלקם זוכים ליד אדם מלטפת. רובם רק לנחת זרועו הקשה.
הזוועות כלפי בעלי החיים הן כל כך שגרתיות ורגילות שאנחנו כבר עיוורים אליהן. הזוועות, האלימות כלפי בעלי החיים היא כל כך שיטתית שהיא כבר לא חדשות. המוצר שמוגש להמונים הוא כל כך מעובד ומגועץ ומחובס שאנחנו לא רואים את נערות הדם שנשפחו בשביל המוצר הזה. בכל אשר תפנו, תעשיית הסתרה, הסתרה של האלימות. התעשייה הזו נדרשת בשביל למכור לכם את הסטייק ואת היוגורט, את הגלולה ואת הבוסם, את המעיל ואת הספה, את זריקות הרעל, את הכרטיסים לגני החיות. בכל אשר תראו, הסתרה אינסופית. אנשים טובים מסתירים ומסתתרים, פוחדים מהמצפון שלהם. אנשים טובים מגייסים את מיטב הרטוריקה שלהם בשביל להסביר ולהצדיק למה הזוועות שאנחנו מעוללים לבעלי החיים אינן רצח ואינן שיבוד ואינן אונס.
נכון, גם החיים שלנו לא תמיד קלים. נכון, גם כלפי בני האדם נעשות הרבה מאוד עוולות נוראיות שיש לעצור ולתקן בדחיפות. אבל בשעה שבה אנחנו מפנים את מבטנו אל אלה שמעלינו ודורשים את הצדק המגיע לנו ולבני אדם אחרים, אנחנו חייבים גם לדעת להעניק אותו לאלה הנמצאים מתחתנו, החלשים מאיתנו, שלא יכולים לדרוש אותו עבור עצמם. כי בכל הליכה לסופר או למסעדה, בין מדפי הקוסמטיקה או בחנות הבגדים, אתם בוחרים האם לפגוע בבעל חיים או להציל אותו.
אנחנו גאים במי שמוכן לדבר למענם, לפעול למענם, לשנות למענם, להשתנות למענם. אנחנו לא משלים את עצמנו שיהיה קל וקצר. אנחנו יודעים שאנחנו פה במאבק לחיים, עד שנוכל להסתכל להם בעיניים. וכמה שהמאבק קשה ומתסכל ומייאש, הלב שלנו אומר לנו שאנחנו ננצח.
מהטמה גנדי
תיאר את שלבי המאבק כך:
בהתחלה מתעלמים ממך.
אחר כך צוחקים עליך.
ואז נלחמים בך.
ובסוף אתה מנצח.
הגיע הזמן להיאבק.
אנו קוראים לכם להסתכל לבעלי החיים בעיניים.
ולבחור אחרת.
לבחור להתנגד לרוע הזה.
להתקומם נגדו.
בכל מקום.
בכל זמן.
בכל דרך.
אנחנו לא מתכוונים לוותר.
נמשיך לצעוק.
לכתוב.
להפגין.
לפרסם.
לעשות מיצגים.
לשחרר.
לתעד.
לשנות ולהשמיע קול.
עד שכל כלוב יהיה ירק. ועד שכל בעל חיים יהיה.
It was the biggest and most impressive demonstration for animal rights in the history of Israel. The demonstration was covered by many media channels, rose the awareness for the topic, and created great enthusiasm both in Israel and around the world. The activists who planned it are already working on other actions. You are also welcome to contribute, because change is in the hands of each and every one of you. Follow us on Facebook. Look into the eyes of the animals.
You know you need CoQ10 and fish oil for your heart. You also know you need a multivitamin to maintain your health. But what you don't know is that an award-winning CoQ10, fish oil, and multivitamin are all made by Life Extension. Why settle for less than the power of science, the power of life, the power of Life Extension?
At Gardens Wellness Center, we provide a full menu of holistic services under one roof. Services to heal the body through chiropractic care, acupuncture, and colon hydrotherapy. And services to heal the mind through hypnotherapy, neurolinguistic programming, and life coaching. We practice functional and Chinese medicine and offer a full herbal pharmacy. Visit us today and take charge of your health.
Find magic again. Sprout by HP. With Intel RealSense technology inside, now you can bend the rules of creativity outside.
This brings us to the end of our special show for today for SOS Pets in Israel and compassion for all life worldwide. I'm Richard Peritz. Thank you for being with us.